Lucy Show, starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Vivian Vance.
Okay, thanks. Let's see now. I have pajamas, handkerchiefs, socks, T-shirts, sweater. Give me that tennis racket there. I think I have everything.
For heaven's sake, Lucy, are you sure Jerry needs all this stuff?
Well, now, it's not my fault. The military academy gave me a list of everything that he would need, and this is it. Help me close this, will you, honey?
Okay.
Tuck it in all around the side there.
Maybe it'd help if we took out the tennis racket.
It might help if we took out my hand.
Oh,
boy, that's...
Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, there's so much
stuff. I know. Well, I'm going to have to rearrange it a little bit.
Hi there, darling.
Hi, sweetheart. Did you say goodbye to all your little friends at the drugstore?
What a farewell blast.
Oh, a blast, huh?
Amy bought me a soda.
Oh, well, that was a grand gesture.
Big deal. One soda, two straws.
Now, Jerry, I hope you shared 50-50 with Amy.
Well, I'm afraid I drank most of it.
Oh, honey.
I couldn't help it. I'm the fastest straw in the West.
Well, I hope you're the fastest dresser in the West, because Colonel Anderson's going to be here to pick you up. Now, hurry up there. Let me rearrange some of this stuff,
okay.
Viv. You know, going to military academy is going to be just wonderful for Jerry.
It sure is. I'm so glad you decided to send him.
Well, he needs male companionship. You know, around here he's with women all the time. And at Longridge Academy, he's going to be completely surrounded by men.
Ooh, I wonder if they'd let me enroll as a cadet.
Let's give this another try here now.
Mom?
Yes, dear.
Has Jerry left yet?
No, he's upstairs putting on his uniform.
Oh, good. I was afraid I wouldn't get to say goodbye.
Dear.
Oh, Lucy, this suitcase is a lost cause.
Come on now, give it a try. Press down
there. How do I look, Mom?
Oh, Jerry.
Oh, Jerry. You look sensational.
Why, you look just like a real soldier, doesn't he, Lucy?
Yeah, a real soldier.
You look so grown up.
Yeah.
Well, you look so handsome in your uniform. Oh, you'll have to have your picture taken, so I'll have it here to look at while you're gone.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Oh, that must be Colonel Anderson.
Oh, don't let him in. Well, what's he doing here?
You know perfectly well what he's doing here. He's taking Jerry to military academy so he'll have male companionship and get him away from women.
Well, what's wrong with women all of a sudden?
Oh, Lucy.
Cadet Carmichael?
Hi, Colonel Anderson.
At Long Ridge Academy, when we address an officer, we say yes, sir, and salute.
Yes, sir.
Now, you get your gear ready, and we'll be moving out.
Yes, sir.
Gear? Moving out?
Oh, Mrs. Carmichael, nice seeing you again.
Nice seeing me again.
Oh, I'm Mrs. Bagley, her friend, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
Mrs. Bagley, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
How do you do, Colonel? And this is Jerry's sister.
How do you
Chrissy?
Do, sir?
Yes. Chrissy? Uh-huh.
Well, we'd better be hurrying along. Are you ready, Cadet Carmichael?
Not quite, Troy. I'm having trouble closing my suitcase.
Yes, yes. We've had a lot of trouble closing that suitcase. I tell you what, I'll go out tomorrow and buy him a larger suitcase, and I'll bring him up to the academy myself tomorrow.
That won't be necessary, Mrs. Carmichael. I've had years of experience with this sort of thing. Allow me.
You see, too much gear, not enough suitcase. Now, look, I'll go out and buy him a larger suitcase tomorrow. Really, I will. And I'll bring him up to the academy first thing tomorrow or the day after, depending how long it takes to get that monogrammed.
I'm sure I can manage. This suitcase will close if it knows what's good for it. After all, I'm the colonel. Mission accomplished.
Well, now, that's using your head.
All right, Cadet Carmichael, we're ready now.
Yes, sir.
Goodbye, honey.
Bye, Mom, sir.
Oh. Look, dear, be sure and wash behind your teeth and brush your ears. And be a good boy, mind the colonel.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Yeah, and honey, I'll be up to see you in a few days.
Mrs. Carmichael, we have a rule at the academy. No parents are allowed to visit the new cadets for the first 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks? That's 14 days.
I'm aware of that. It was all in the brochure we sent you about the academy.
Well, I'm afraid I missed that.
Well, for long years of experience, we have learned that our policy is beneficial both for the child and the parent during the cadet's orientation period. Well, shall we go, cadet?
Yes, sir.
Honey, don't forget to write now, and I'll be up to see you in 2 weeks. 1 minute after midnight. Yeah. Wait a minute. I forgot. Here's some postcards, honey. They're all stamped and addressed, and you write me twice a day, the minute you get up before you go to bed at night. From Jerry. I thought sure I'd get a postcard.
Lucy just left yesterday afternoon. There's no way he could have sent you one unless he mailed it on his way out of town.
Well, I just want to know if he got there safely. There's a lot of traffic on that road, you know.
With Colonel Anderson in charge, he don't have a thing to worry about. If traffic gets too heavy, he'll sit on it.
Dear. I know what I'm going to do.
What are you going to do?
I don't know why I didn't think of this before. I'll call him. Oh. Hello? Hello, this is Mrs. Carmichael. May I speak to my son, Jerry, please? Pardon? Well, yes, I knew it was against the rules to visit them for the first 2 weeks, but I never dreamed you weren't allowed to speak to them on the phone. Hello? Hello? I guess they got another call.
Against the rules, huh?
Apparently. They sure have a lot of rules around there. Colonel Anderson runs it like it was a jail or something. You'd think they'd give a little boy one call to his mother. I know a way to get to talk to him.
Long Ridge Military Academy. This is long distance. I have a call for Jerry Carmichael from Long Beach, California. I have my party on the line. Go ahead, Lovely.
Hello, this is Abigail Carmichael, Jerry's 99-year-old great-grandmother. I was wondering if I could speak to the little nipper. Against the rules. Well, at my age, I don't pay attention to rules. Rules, 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 push, tush. So, young man, if you'll just skedaddle and put my great-grandson on the line, I'd appreciate it.
Well, the same to you, Corporal. Now, how did he know that was me?
Oh, look, Lucy, you might as well be patient, and in 2 weeks you can go up to the school and spend a whole afternoon with Jerry.
2 weeks is such a long time. What if he's changed so much I don't recognize him? I could spend the whole afternoon with the wrong boy. Viv, I finally found that picture of Jerry at the beach.
Another picture? Don't you think you have enough pictures of Jerry around this room?
Well, these pictures are all I have. These are my memories.
Oh, Lucy, he's only been gone for 3 days.
Well, it's easy for you to talk. You still have your Sherman at home. He hasn't answered his country's call yet.
School. He isn't overseas.
Well, he might as well be overseas. I can't visit him, and every time I call him, they won't let me talk to him.
Well, for goodness sakes, you've got pictures of him from the time he was 1 week old to 10 years. If you turn your head fast, he grows up right there.
Well, thank goodness I've got these pictures. He's going to be at Long Ridge until he's a senior. Then he's going to go to college, and then he'll get married. And if I know that wife of his, she'll never let me visit him.
Lucy, get hold of yourself.
Wonder where I should put these.
Back in the attic where you found them.
Never mind. I'm going to put them right there.
Honestly, I'm surprised you didn't dig up a curl from his first haircut.
Oh, would you like to see it, Bill?
Oh, Lucy, you're just being ridiculous.
ridiculous.
Well, I don't care. I'm so worried about him. How do I know he's all right?
Because he's in a very good school, and they're taking very good care of him. Now, you can rest... The mailman! That's the mailman!
Good morning, Mrs. Carmichael.
It's from Jerry!
Oh, thank you.
Dear Mom. Dear Mom, he still remembers me. They blow the bugle at 6:30 and we have to get up. I eat everything on my plate. Say hello to everybody. Having a wonderful time. Your son, Jerry.
See, what'd I tell you? You have nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about. That's what you think. I can read between the lines.
What do you mean between the lines?
They blow the bugle at 6:30 and he has to get up. Has to get up. He doesn't want to get up. You know that. He likes to stay in bed and hide under the covers. He hates it there.
Oh, Lucy.
And get this. I eat everything on my plate. You know he always leaves something. Why does he eat everything on his plate? Because they don't give him enough. They're starving him to death.
Come now.
Look at this. Having a wonderful time. Now, what comes after having a wonderful time?
A period.
I don't mean that. I mean the expression, having a wonderful time. What comes after that? Wish you were here. He wishes I were there. That's what. And you know why? Because the poor little darling is homesick, sleepy, and half crazed with hunger.
Oh, now, if he felt like that, don't you think he would tell you?
How could he? He wouldn't dare tell me the truth because of military censorship.
Oh, Lucy.
I'm going up to that academy right now.
Now, remember the rule. You can't visit a cadet for 2 weeks.
Vivian, my place is with my son in the trenches.
Ma'am?
I'd like to see Colonel Anderson, please. I'm Mrs. Carmichael.
Yes, ma'am. Won't you have a seat?
Oh, thank you, sir.
Colonel Anderson, sir? I'm Mrs. Carmichael to see you. Yes, sir. He'll be right out, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Military Academy?
Beg your pardon, ma'am?
Well, those guns and the way you're dressed.
These uniforms are for training maneuvers, ma'am.
Oh. Oh, training maneuvers.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh.
Clark, give this uniform to George Curry when he gets off sentry duty.
Right.
At ease. Well, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, Colonel Anderson, how are you, sir?
You know, I wasn't expecting a visit from you until 1 minute after midnight, 11 days from now.
I know, and I'd like to say that that's a wonderful rule you have about parents not being allowed to visit for the first 2 weeks.
Yes, we think it's a wonderful rule, too, and I'm certainly delighted you're in accord with our policy. So what are you doing here now?
Oh, well, believe me, sir, I would not be here unless this was a very special occasion. You see, it's little Jerry's birthday, and he and I always celebrate together.
How sweet.
Yes, and I brought a very large cake so he can share with his fellow cadets. So if you'll just show me where his room is, I'll just run in and light the candles on the cake and cut the cake and pass the paper hats and pin the tail on the donkey and run right out again.
That is a really delightful idea, and I would be in accord with it except for one thing.
Oh, what's that, sir?
According to your son's application, his birthday was 3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago?
Yes.
Oh, dear. Well, if his birthday was 3 weeks ago and I missed it, then I've got to take him the cake so that he knows that his mommy didn't forget him completely.
Now, Mrs. Carmichael, there's no use what's going on with this. Both you and I know why you're here. So give me the cake, and I will see that Jerry and his friends get it.
But you don't know what it's like being separated from your only son for the first time. You don't know what we mothers go through.
You don't know what I go through because of what you mothers go through.
What do you mean by that?
Cadet Clark.
Yes, sir.
cake every night of the semester, thanks to mother love and a large freezer. Cadet Clark.
Yes, sir?
Will you please show Mrs. Carmichael to the gate?
The gate, sir?
Yes, the gate.
Yes, sir.
Goodbye, Mrs. Carmichael. And we will see you on the first visiting day.
Yes, sir.
Pardon me a moment, ma'am. Reception desk, Cadet Clark speaking. Yes, sir. Uniform for the day is lower classman dress, intermediate classman fatigues, upperclassman training maneuver uniforms. Yes, sir. Obstacle course training schedule 1300. Drill 1400. No, sir. Only if it rains. No, sir. I don't think that'll happen. Roger. Yes, sir. I beg your pardon for the delay, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, that's quite all right. Cadet Clark.
Yes, ma'am?
Just so I don't waste any time when I come on visiting day, could you give me an idea where Cadet Carmichael is bivouacked or bunked or whatever it is you call it?
Oh, he's in Wellington Hall.
Oh, he's in Wellington Hall. Oh, I see. And just where is that?
Well, through these doors, across the drill field, and past the library.
Oh, through these doors, across the drill field, and past the library.
Yes, ma'am.
I see. Thank you. Oh, yes.
Before.
No, sir.
Oh, you must be that transfer from Rockingham.
Transfer from Rockingham.
Yes, and your name is Cadet Cosgrove.
Cosgrove.
Well, fall in, Cadet Cosgrove. Over there. Left. Face. Over there on the end of the line, Cosgrove. Now, you know, men, your parents have asked us to make you complete soldiers. Cosgrove! Chin in! Shoulders back! Stomach in! Eyes front! Now today, we'll practice assembling rifles. And I want it done under the 35-second record. Yahoo!
How was that again?
Yahoo! Course. Left shoulder, hops, right, face, forward, perch. Cosgrove, fall in line. Hut, hut, toe, break, bar, hut, toe, break, bar, hut, toe, break, bar, hut, toe, break, bar, one, hop, hut, toe. Cosgrove, left, face. Now we'll examiner at the optical course. Hi-ho, boo there. Cadet Thornton will illustrate to you how to run the obstacle course. Are you ready, Cadet Thornton? Hit it! Go! 1, 2, on the double, everything on the double. Swing there, boy. Swing back there. That's it. Now, up and over! That's the way. Move that pipe there. Go. Go there, then. Very good, Cadet Thornton. Now, in this order, Blake, Kelly, Cosgrove, Snyder, Altman, hit it! Go! What?
You said about not being quite ready for Longridge, and I agree.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. That's right. We have to think of his emotional insecurity, Colonel.
Well, I wasn't thinking of his as much as I was thinking of yours, Mrs. Carmichael. Now, why don't you two gather your gear and trot along home and come back and see us in, oh, maybe a couple of years?
Oh, Colonel Addison, you act stern and gruff, but inside you're just a big old cuddly honey bear.
What?
Sir?
And jump. Right, face. Forward, hunch. One, two, three.
much I don't recognize him. I could spend the whole afternoon with the wrong boy. Viv, I finally found that picture of Jerry at the beach.
Another picture? Don't you think you have enough pictures of Jerry around this room?
Well, these pictures are all I have. These are my memories.
Oh, Lucy, he's only been gone for 3 days.
Well, it's easy for you to talk. You still have your Sherman at home. He hasn't answered his country's call yet.
Oh, he's only gone to military school. He isn't overseas.
Well, he might as well be overseas. I can't visit him, and every time I call him, they won't let me talk to him.
Well, for goodness sakes, you've got pictures of him from the time he was 1 week old to 10 years. If you turn your head fast, he grows up right there.
Well, thank goodness I've got these pictures. He's going to be at Longridge until he's a senior. Then he's going to go to college. And then he'll get married. And if I know that wife of his, she'll never let me visit him.
Lucy, get hold of yourself.
Wonder where I should put these.
Back in the attic where you found them.
Never mind. I'm going to put them right there.
Honestly, I'm surprised you didn't dig up a curl from his first haircut.
Oh, would you like to see it, Viv?
Oh, Lucy, you're just being ridiculous.
Well, I don't care. I'm so worried about him. How do I know he's all right?
Because he's in a very good school, and they're taking very good care of him. Now, you can rest...
The mailman! That's the mailman!
Good morning, Mrs. Good morning. Carmichael.
It's from Jerry!
Oh, thank you.
Dear Mom. Dear Mom, he still remembers me. They blow the bugle at 6:30 and we have to get up. I eat everything on my plate. Say hello to everybody. Having a wonderful time. Your son, Jerry.
See, what did I tell you? You have nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about. That's what you think. I can read between the lines.
What do you mean between the lines?
They blow the bugle at 6:30 and he has to get up. Has to get up. He doesn't want to get up. You know that. He likes to stay in bed and hide under the covers. He hates it there.
Oh, Lucy.
And get this. I eat everything on my plate. You know he always leaves something. Why does he eat everything on his plate? Because they don't give him enough. They're starving him to death.
Come now.
Look at this. Having a wonderful time. Now, what comes after having a wonderful time?
A period.
I don't mean that. I mean the expression, having a wonderful time. What comes after that? Wish you were here. He wishes I were there. That's what. And you know why? Because the poor little darling is homesick, sleepy, and half crazed with hunger.
Oh, now, if he felt like that, don't you think he would tell you?
How could he? He wouldn't dare tell me the truth because of military censorship.
Oh, Lucy.
I'm going up to that academy right now.
Now, remember the rule. You can't visit a cadet for 2 weeks.
Vivian, my place is with my son in the trenches.
Ma'am?
I'd like to see Colonel Anderson, please. I'm Mrs. Carmichael.
Yes, ma'am. Won't you have a seat?
Oh, thank you, sir.
Colonel Anderson, sir? I'm Mrs. Carmichael to see you. Yes, sir. He'll be right out, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Military Academy?
Beg your pardon, ma'am?
Well, those guns and the way you're dressed.
These uniforms are for training maneuvers, ma'am.
Oh. Oh, training maneuvers.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh.
Clark, give this uniform to George Curry when he gets off sentry duty.
Right.
At ease. Well, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, Colonel Anderson, how are you, sir?
You know, I wasn't expecting a visit from you until 1 minute after midnight, 11 days from now.
I know, and I'd like to say that that's a wonderful rule you have about parents not being allowed to visit for the first 2 weeks.
Yes, we think it's a wonderful rule, too, and I'm certainly delighted you're in accord with our policy. So what are you doing here now?
Oh, well, believe me, sir, I would not be here unless this was a very special occasion. You see, it's little Jerry's birthday, and he and I always celebrate together.
How sweet.
Yes, and I brought a very large cake so he can share with his fellow cadets. So if you'll just show me where his room is, I'll just run in and light the candles on the cake and cut the cake and pass the paper hats and pin the tail on the donkey and run right out again.
Well, that is really a delightful idea. I would be in accord with it, except for one thing.
Oh, what's that, sir?
According to your son's application, his birthday was 3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago?
Yes.
Oh, dear. Well, if his birthday was 3 weeks ago and I missed it, then I've got to take him the cake so that he knows that his mommy didn't forget him completely.
Now, Mrs. Carmichael, there's no use what's going on with this. Both you and I know why you're here. So give me the cake and I will see that Jerry and his friends get it.
But you don't know what it's like being separated from your only son for the first time. You don't know what we mothers go through.
You don't know what I go through because of what you mothers go through.
What do you mean by that?
Cadet Clark.
Yes, sir.
We have homemade cake every night of the semester, thanks to mother love and a large freezer. Cadet Clark.
Yes, sir.
Will you please show Mrs. Carmichael to the gate?
The gate, sir?
Yes, the gate.
Yes, sir.
Goodbye, Mrs. Carmichael. And we will see you on the first visiting day.
Yes, sir.
Pardon me a moment, ma'am. Reception desk, Cadet Clark speaking. Yes, sir. Uniform for the day is lower classman dress, intermediate classman fatigues, upper classman training maneuver uniforms. Yes, sir. Obstacle course training schedule 1300. Drill 1400. No, sir. Only if it rains. No, sir. I don't think that'll happen. Roger. Yes, sir. I beg your pardon for the delay, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, that's quite all right. Cadet Clark.
Yes, ma'am?
Just so I don't waste any time when I come on visiting day, could you give me an idea where Cadet Carmichael is bivouacked or bunked or whatever it is you call it?
Oh, he's in Wellington Hall.
Oh, he's in Wellington Hall. Oh, I see. And just where is that?
Well, through these doors.
Uh-huh.
Across the drill field.
Mm-hmm.
And past the library.
Oh, through these doors and across the drill.
The Lucy Show, starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Vivian Vance.
Okay, thanks. Let's see now. I have pajamas, handkerchiefs, socks, T-shirt, sweater. Give me that tennis racket there. I think I have everything.
For heaven's sake, Lucy, are you sure Jerry needs all this stuff?
Well, now, it's not my fault. The military academy gave me a list of everything that he would need, and this is it. Help me close this, will you, honey?
Okay.
Tuck it in all around the side there.
Maybe it'd help if we took out the tennis racket.
It might help if we took out my hand.
Oh!
Ah, boy, that's...
Sorry.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, there's so much stuff.
I know. Well, I'm going to have to rearrange it a bit.
Hi there, darling.
Hi, sweetheart. Did you say goodbye to all your little friends at the drugstore?
What a farewell blast.
Oh, a blast, huh?
Amy bought me a soda.
Oh, well, that was a grand gesture.
big deal, one soda, two straws.
Now, Jerry, I hope you shared 50-50 with Amy.
Well, I'm afraid I drank most of it.
Oh, honey.
I couldn't help it. I'm the fastest straw in the West.
Fastest straw in the West.
Well, I hope you're the fastest dresser in the West, because Colonel Anderson's going to be here to pick you up. Now, hurry up there. Let me rearrange some of this stuff, okay. Viv. You know, going to military academy is going to be just wonderful for Jerry.
It sure is. I'm so glad you decided to send him.
Well, he needs male companionship. You know, around here he's with women all the time. And at Long Ridge Academy, he's going to be completely surrounded by men.
Ooh, I wonder if they'd let me enroll as a cadet.
Let's give this another try here now.
Mom?
Yes, dear.
Has Jerry left yet?
No, he's upstairs putting on his uniform.
Oh, good. I was afraid I wouldn't get to say goodbye.
Dear.
Oh, Lucy, this suitcase is a lost cause.
Come on now, give it a try. Press down there.
How do I look, Mom?
Oh, Jerry.
Oh, Jerry. You look sensational.
Why, you look just like a real soldier, doesn't he, Lucy?
Yeah, a real soldier.
You look so grown up.
Yeah.
Oh, you look so handsome in your uniform. Oh, you'll have to have your picture taken, so I'll have it here to look at while you're gone.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Oh, that must be Colonel Anderson.
Gone. Oh, don't let him in. Well, what's he doing here?
You know perfectly well what he's doing here. He's taking Jerry to military academy, so he'll have male companionship and get him away from women.
Well, what's wrong with women all of a sudden?
Oh, Lucy.
Cadet Carmichael?
Hi, Colonel Anderson.
At Long Ridge Academy, when we address an officer, we say yes, sir, and salute.
Yes, sir.
Now, you get your gear ready, and we'll be moving out.
Yes, sir.
Gear? Moving out?
Oh, Mrs. Carmichael, nice seeing you again.
Nice seeing me again.
Oh, I'm Mrs. Bagley, her friend, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
Mrs. Bagley, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
How do you do, Colonel? And this is Jerry's sister.
How do you
Chrissy?
Do, sir?
Yeah.
Chrissy?
Uh-huh.
Well, we'd better be hurrying along. Are you ready, Cadet Carmichael?
Not quite, Troy. I'm having trouble closing my suitcase.
Yes, yes. We've had a lot of trouble closing that suitcase. I tell you what, I'll go out tomorrow and buy him a larger suitcase, and I'll bring him up to the academy myself tomorrow.
That won't be necessary, Mrs. Carmichael. I've had years of experience with this sort of thing. Allow me.
You see? You see? Too much gear, not enough suitcase. Now, look, I'll go out and buy him a larger suitcase tomorrow. Really, I will. And I'll bring him up to the academy first thing tomorrow. Or the day after, depending how long it takes to get that monogrammed.
I'm sure I can manage. This suitcase will close if it knows what's good for it. After all, I'm the colonel. Mission accomplished.
Well, now, that's using your head.
All right, Cadet Carmichael, we're ready now.
Yes, sir.
Goodbye, goodbye, honey.
Bye, Mom, sir.
Oh, look, dear, be sure and wash behind your teeth and brush your ears. And be a good boy, mind the colonel.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Yeah, and, honey, I'll be up to see you in a few days.
Mrs. Carmichael, we have a rule at the academy. No parents are allowed to visit the new cadets for the first 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks? That's 14 days.
I'm aware of that. It was all in the brochure we sent you about the academy.
Well, I'm afraid I missed that.
Well, for long years of experience, we have learned that our policy is beneficial both for the child and the parent during the cadet's orientation period. Well, shall we go, cadet?
Yes, sir.
Honey, don't forget to write now, and I'll be up to see you in 2 weeks. 1 minute after midnight. Yeah. Wait a minute. I forgot. Here's some postcards, honey. They're all stamped and addressed, and you write me twice a day. The minute you get up before you go to bed at night.
Goodbye, Jerry.
Have a wonderful time, Jerry.
Goodbye, honey. Mail
from Jerry. I thought sure I'd get a postcard.
Lucy just left yesterday afternoon. There's no way he could have sent you one unless he mailed it on his way out of town.
Well, I just want to know if he got there safely. There's a lot of traffic on that road, you know.
With Colonel Anderson in charge, he don't have a thing to worry about. If traffic gets too heavy, he'll sit on it.
Here. I know what I'm going to do.
What are you going to do?
I don't know why I didn't think of this before. I'll call him. Oh. Hello? Hello, this is Mrs. Carmichael. May I speak to my son, Jerry, please? Pardon? Well, yes, I knew it was against the rules to visit them for the first 2 weeks, but I never dreamed you weren't allowed to speak to them on the phone. Hello? Hello? I guess they got another call.
Against the rules, huh?
Apparently. They sure have a lot of rules around there. Colonel Anderson runs it like it was a jail or something. You'd think they'd give a little boy one call to his mother. I know a way to get to talk to him.
Long Ridge Military Academy? This is long distance. I have a call for Jerry Carmichael from Long Beach, California. I have my party on the line. Go ahead, Lovey.
Hello, this is Abigail Carmichael, Jerry's 99-year-old great-grandmother. I was wondering if I could speak to the little nipper. Against the rules. Well, at my age, I don't pay attention to rules. Rules, 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 push, tush. So, young man, if you would just skedaddle and put my great-grandson on the line, I'd appreciate it.
Well, the same to you, Corporal. Now, how did he know that was me?
Oh, look, Lucy, you might as well be patient, and in 2 weeks you can go up to the school and spend a whole afternoon with Jerry.
Drill field and past the library.
Yes, ma'am.
I see. Thank you. Oh, yes.
Before.
No, sir.
You must be that transfer from Rockingham.
Transfer from Rockingham.
Yes, and your name is Cadet Cosgrove.
Cosgrove.
Well, foreign Cadet Cosgrove. Over there. Left. Face. Over there on the end of the line, Cosgrove. Now, you know, men, your parents have asked us to make you complete soldiers. Cosgrove! Chin in! Shoulder back! Stomach in! Eyes front! Now today, we'll practice assembling rifles. And I want it done under the 35-second record. Yahoo!
How was that again?
Yahoo! Proceed to the obstacle course. Left shoulder, hops, right.
Ready? Forward. Patch!
Hargrove! Fall in line! Hargrove! Hut to great par! Hut to great par! Hut to great par! Hut to great par! What? Hop! Hut to!
Hargrove!
Left face!
Now we'll fall out and assemble at the obstacle course. Hi, old bull there. Cadet Thornton will illustrate to you how to run the obstacle course. Are you ready, Cadet Thornton? Hit it! Go! One, two, on the double. Everything on the double. Swing there, boy. Swing there. That's it. Now, up and over. That's the way. Put that pipe there. Go. Go there, man. Pray with Cadet Thornton. Now, in this order, Blake, Kelly, Cosgrove, Snyder, Altman. Hit it! Go! What? Batman!
You look just like a real soldier, doesn't he, Lucy?
Yeah, a real soldier.
You look so grown up.
Yeah.
Oh, you look so handsome in your uniform. Oh, you'll have to have your picture taken, so I'll have it here to look at while you're gone.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh, that must be Colonel Anderson. Oh, don't let him in. Well, what's he doing here?
You know perfectly well what he's doing here. He's taking Jerry to military academy, so he'll have male companionship and get him away from women.
Well, what's wrong with women all of a sudden?
Oh, Lucy.
Cadet Carmichael?
Hi, Colonel Anderson.
At Long Ridge Academy, when we address an officer, we say yes, sir, and salute.
Yes, sir.
Now, you get your gear ready, and we'll be moving out.
Yes, sir.
Gear? Moving out?
Oh, Mrs. Carmichael, nice seeing you again.
Nice seeing me again.
Oh, I'm Mrs. Bagley, her friend, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
Mrs. Bagley, Mrs. Carmichael's friend.
How do you do, Colonel? And this is Jerry's sister.
How do you
Chrissy?
Do, sir? Yeah.
Chrissy?
Uh-huh.
Well, we'd better be hurrying up.
The Lucy Show. Starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Vivian Vance.
Okay, thanks. Let's see now. I have pajamas, handkerchiefs, socks, T-shirts, sweater. Give me that tennis racket there. I think I have everything.
For heaven's sake, Lucy, are you sure Jerry needs all this stuff?
Well, now, it's not my fault. The military academy gave me a list of everything that he would need, and this is it. Help me close this, will you, honey?
Okay.
Tuck it in all around the side there.
Maybe it'd help if we took out the tennis racket.
It might help if we took out my hand.
Oh,
boy, that's...
Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, there's so much stuff.
I know. Well, I'm going to have to rearrange it a little bit.
Hi there, darling.
Hi, sweetheart. Did you say goodbye to all your little friends at the drugstore?
What a farewell.
Come on. Are you ready, Cadet Carmichael?
Not quite sure. I'm having trouble closing my suitcase.
Yes, yes. We've had a lot of trouble closing that suitcase. I tell you what, I'll go out tomorrow and buy him a larger suitcase, and I'll bring him up to the academy myself tomorrow.
That won't be necessary, Mrs. Carmichael. I've had years of experience with this sort of thing. Allow me.
You see, too much gear, not enough suitcase. Now, look, I'll go out and buy him a larger suitcase tomorrow. Really, I will. And I'll bring him up to the academy first thing tomorrow or the day after, depending how long it takes to get that monogrammed.
I'm sure I can manage. This suitcase will close if it knows what's good for it. After all, I'm the colonel. Mission accomplished.
Well, now, that's using your head.
Right, Cadet Carmichael, we're ready now.
Goodbye, honey.
Bye, Mom, sure.
Oh. Look, dear, be sure and wash behind your teeth and brush your ears. And be a good boy, mind the Colonel.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Yeah, and honey, I'll be up to see you in a few days.
Mrs. Carmichael, we have a rule at the Academy, no parents are...
Well, blast.
Oh, a blast, huh?
Amy bought me a soda.
Oh, well, that was a grand gesture.
Big deal, one soda, two straws.
Now, Jerry, I hope you shared 50-50 with Amy.
Well, I'm afraid I drank most of it.
Oh, honey.
I couldn't help it. I'm the fastest straw in the West.
Fastest straw in the West.
Well, I hope you're the fastest dresser in the West, because Colonel Anderson's going to be here to pick you up. Now, hurry up there. Let me rearrange some of this stuff, okay. Viv. You know, going to Military Academy is going to be just wonderful for Jerry.
It sure is. I'm so glad you decided to send him.
Well, he needs male companionship. You know, around here he's with women all the time. And at Long Ridge Academy, he's going to be completely surrounded by men.
Ooh, I wonder if they'd let me enroll as a cadet.
Let's give this another try here now.
Mom?
Yes, dear.
Has Jerry left yet?
No, he's upstairs putting on his uniform.
Oh, good. I was afraid I wouldn't get to say goodbye.
Dear.
Oh, Lucy, this suitcase is a lost cause.
Come on now, give it a try. Press down
there. How do I look, Mom?
Oh, Jerry.
Oh, Jerry. You look sensational.
Allowed to visit the new cadets for the first 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks? That's 14 days.
I'm aware of that. It was all in the brochure we sent you about the academy.
Well, I'm afraid I missed that.
Well, for long years of experience, we have learned that our policy is beneficial both for the child and the parent during the cadets' orientation period. Well, shall we go, cadet?
Yes, sir.
Honey, don't forget to write now, and I'll be up to see you in 2 weeks. 1 minute after midnight. Yeah. Wait a minute. I forgot. Here's some postcards, honey. They're all stamped and addressed, and you write me twice a day. The minute you get up before you go to bed at night.
Bye, Jerry. Have a wonderful time, Jerry.
Goodbye, honey. From Jerry. I thought sure I'd get a postcard.
Lucy just left yesterday afternoon. There's no way he could have sent you one unless he mailed it on his way out of town.
Well, I just want to know if he got there safely. There's a lot of traffic on that road, you know.